The situation of law and order in our city is getting out of control by the day. They've become so courageous that they're doing crimes openly. They're looting public in broad daylight. People are petrified and we are just keeping mum.
Sorry to interrupt, sir. We do arrest the criminals, but then we get orders from superiors or there is some political pressure. And then the common public, they don't cooperate with us. They just complain about everything.
That's all okay, Inspector Vishal Bhargav. A policeman's job is a thankless job. And its responsibility is very important and challenging. If we get public in our confidence, then our job will get very easy. But for that, every officer should be aware of their responsibility as well as be alert.
Hey! Don't move! Miss Suhasini Rastogi, you are under arrest.
Huh? So, you will arrest me?
Not me, then who will do it?
Hey, but the one who is already arrested, how will he arrest me?
Mm-hmm. Well, you are right.
Can I ask you, why did you do all this drama today?
It was very much needed, Miss Suhasini Rastogi, because our friendship and our relationship, it's too old now.
Okay. So now, you want to break this?
Mm-hmm. I want to take it ahead. By the way, what are your thoughts on marriage?
My thoughts about the marriage? It's quite good.
Oh my, good.
Then come with me. Come and talk to mom and dad.
No, not me. You talk to your mom and dad, and I will talk to my mom and dad. All right? Jai Hind.
No, wait. Such a silly cop.
Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes, I'm listening to you. Why are you yelling?
What? Do you think I'm yelling at you? I thought when people grow old, they happen to listen very less. But in your case, it's completely opposite. You're listening more than usual.
Oh, that's great. So now you want me to be deaf.
No matter what I say, you always take it in a wrong way.
If you talk like this, then I'll surely take it in a wrong way. I wanted a cup of tea. You could have given it to me and the matter would have been over.
That's exactly what I'm doing.
Okay, then you also have it, please.
Mama, before having tea, have some sweets.
Sweets?
What is this for?
That Vishal is agreed for marriage.
Oh, wow. Great. Wow, Suhasini, that's a great news.
Didn't I tell you? That boy Vishal is a very good boy.
You never told that. I used to tell it every time.
When did you say that?
Listen.
I had said that.
Oh.
Mummy, take it.
Suhasini,
So, dear, I should also get it?
No, you have to avoid it.
Okay, then at least you have some. Wow.
You have some. God bless you.
God bless you.
Dad, have it. Mom,
oh, wow,
for you.
Fantastic, fantastic. God bless you, God bless you.
God bless you.
Wow, really? Today's sweet is really phenomenal.
Of course it's different. It's his marriage news for which he bought us sweets.
Yes, so let's do one thing. Let's get him married very soon.
Come on, Dad. What is the need of these formalities?
Scheme.
What is the need of engagement, Mom?
Right.
From within, he's extremely excited.
Yeah.
He's behaving like a child. I understand.
Yeah.
Mummy? Mummy? Okay, Daddy, I'm leaving.
But where are you going?
Daddy, I'm getting late for office.
Suhasini, it's your engagement today. You're going to the office.
Please, Daddy. It is really important. But I will come early, okay?
I don't understand why you're so stubborn. Okay, if it's important, then you should go. I won't stop you.
Yes.
But your in-laws will be here by 6 p.m. You should come back by 4 p.m. train, all right?
Yes, Dad.
Till then, I'll finish my work.
No, Dad. I will get the things once I'm coming back to home, okay? Okay, Mommy, I'm leaving.
Where are you going?
I will back home soon, okay? Bye.
But Suhasini, listen to me. Where is she going?
To the office.
Today, office?
I want to tell you something, Lakshmi.
Yes?
If we had a son, he wouldn't have given us this happiness which our daughter has given us.
Yes, you're right.
Congratulations! Congratulations!
Thank you. But about the engagement, how did you all come to know?
How did we know? Your fiancé told us about it.
Oh, God.
Okay, it's almost done. Oh, it's done as well. Good. Lakshmi! Lakshmi! Please do it a little faster. Huh? Lakshmi!
What is it? Go slowly. Why are you yelling at me again now?
Oh, I'm not shouting at you. Your ears are not working properly.
All right. So you want to fight with me again? Is that why you called me here?
No, I called you to see the decoration which has been done. Food and beverages are all set. Huh? Hmm?
It's all perfect.
I have made sure that this decoration matches to their standards. Tell me one thing, Lakshmi. When Suhasini goes to work, I feel very happy. But I don't know why I'm so sad today. Why so?
Now that your daughter is getting married, it's very natural to get these thoughts. Once Suhasini will get married and leave this house, then we will be left all alone.
That's why. We need a son along with a daughter. Daughter has to leave the house, but son gets a daughter-in-law, right?
You're getting these thoughts very late,
Is it so?
May I come in, sir?
Suhasini, come, come.
Sir, I need to go home early today.
I'm very angry with you, Suhasini.
What happened, sir?
Is this the time to inform this? You are telling me this at 3 p.m. I know why you want to leave early today. It's your engagement, right? But tell me one thing, why even have you come to office today?
Sir, that work...
Work, work. How much will you work? There is hell lot of thing in the life other than the work. Like your engagement. Tell me, will you accept my congratulations?
Yes, sir.
Yes, congratulations. My good wishes are with you.
Thank you, sir.
Suhasini, are you planning to leave the job after marriage?
No, sir. I won't leave this job. Because in today's time, sir, a wife has to be a support system to her husband and help him in every way. She should share the burden of responsibilities of her husband.
Good. I felt very nice after hearing your thoughts. Every girl should have this thought in her mind. It's necessary that both husband and wife share the responsibility equally. You go to your home, everyone must be waiting for you.
Thank you, sir.
Suhasini, are you listening to what I'm saying?
No, where?
Okay, my station has come. I should leave. Okay, bye.
Bye. Coming in engagement,
yes,
no?
Yes, we'll go home, get fresh. I'll be on time. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Be on time.
Yes, yes, bye. Sure.
What happened, my son?
Nothing, Dad.
Oh, looks like someone is remembering you.
I think he's getting eager now.
Mr. Priest, I hope it doesn't get late.
Yes, sir. The auspicious time is of 7 p.m.
Auspicious time is 7 p.m. Oh, Mr. Anand.
Yes?
Please come here. Please call Suhasini. Auspicious time is running away.
Yes, yes. I'll be back soon. Listen, please come here.
Excuse me.
It's gotten very late. Where is Suhasini? We need to find out. Where has she gone? Let's see. Let's find out.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, Kulkarni. Excuse me. What happened, Kulkarni?
Sir, I'm sorry to disturb you. It's an emergency and you have to leave immediately. There has been a bomb blast in train and many people are injured. It's a very emergency case, sir.
What?
Yes, sir.
Okay, come.
My son, what is the issue?
Nothing, Dad. It's an emergency call. I will come soon.
But
wait.
It's already 6:30. Still, she's not home.
I don't understand why she's so late.
I told her to come early. I will see. Suhasini, dear?
Yes, uncle.
Vishal's mother and father have come. There are so many other guests. Get up, please. Get up, dear. Get up. Get up, dear.
Get up, dear. Get up.
They will get wrong impression about you. You have to even get ready. Get up. Get up, dear. Get up.
Everything is over. Get up, my child. Get up.
Vishal, Suhasini has left us alone. Suhasini has left us alone.
Suhasini, you left me all alone. We had seen so many dreams together. You had promised me that you will never leave me alone. My dreams, it's all shattered in a second. I thought I will spend my entire life with you. But the fate has separated us. Death has separated you from me. This is unfair, Suhasini. This is really unfair. But I promise, Suhasini, those who have done this with you, they will suffer for this. They will definitely suffer for this.
Today, girls are no less than any guy. In fact, they are taking all required efforts equally with the men. And there are even some professions in which they are even ahead of them.
Suhasini, I don't deny what you said. You are not our daughter, but just like a son. But dear, we have our own traditions. We are bonded by values. Just like ideals, social norms which we all follow. Okay, I hope you know that. Let's assume we both are dead. Then according to tradition, who will perform the last rites?
Mummy, Papa, I always pray to God that you both should always and always should be with me. But since you have asked this question, then as a daughter, I will definitely answer this. If it will require, then I will break this tradition. And fire to your body will be given by your Suhasini.
Suhasini?
And fire to your body will be given by your Suhasini.
Suhasini, you have left us and gone. Now there is nothing left for us in this world.
Suhasini, you have left us in darkness forever. We have lost everything today. We are left with nothing, Suhasini. Nothing left for us.
No, Uncle. Whatever you have lost, I will try my level best to fulfill that void. You have lost your daughter. But your son is there for you. I am always there for you, Uncle.
Vishal.
Yes, Uncle. In these difficult times, you both are not alone. Suhasini was always worried about you both. I am there for you both. But I am sad because I have lost her forever. I have lost her forever. Come in, sir.
Yes, Vishal.
Sir.
Tell me, Vishal. Any progress in bomb blast case?
We have arrested some suspected ones, sir. Among them are some of the tobacco sellers, some people from law organizations that are arrested as well. We have set barricades everywhere possible. Tonight, whoever will get arrested, they will go through inquiry procedure. And to identify them, we have called people who work for railways and also the people who were injured in the attack. They will help us in the identification.
It means that we don't have any clue against the criminals behind this.
Right, sir. But I'm confident that after this inquiry procedure, we will definitely get some clue.
I hope so.
Thank you, sir.
Let him go. Come ahead. Oh, okay. Show your license. And you guys check inside. Check properly. Okay. You may go. Come ahead. Come ahead. License. Check inside. Check there as well. Yes. Let them go. Note the number of the car. Okay. Where are you coming from? You check them properly. Yes, yes. Jai Hind, sir.
Kulkarni.
Yes, sir.
Every car that passes from here, it has to be checked very
yes,
properly.
Yes, sir.
Every name and address should be noted.
Right,
and report
sir.
Me the progress.
Okay. Stop! Suhasini? Suhasini, along with your ashes, all my expectations and all my dreams have been burned to ashes. I am feeling very lonely without you. I am all alone. I miss you so much. But Suhasini, whoever has done this with you and with all those innocent people, I will not spare them. I promise you, Suhasini, they have no idea what they're about to face. Tomorrow we're having an inquiry. And I'm sure
that the one who is behind all of this will get identified tomorrow.
The suspected people you've arrested, they are not related to the attack, Vishal.
Suhasini, you...
Wait, Vishal. Don't come ahead.
Suhasini?
Don't come close to me. I'm not alive. I'm the soul. I just came here to tell you this, that all the suspects you've arrested, out of that, none of them about this bomb blast is related. They all are innocent.
What are you saying, Suhasini? They are all related to this attack. Their names are registered in the police records.
Must be there. But none of them are responsible for this bomb blast. The real culprit is still walking freely. And he's planning for another attack. To make it successful, he's preparing.
Who is he? Where is he?
I will tell you. But you will have to wait for some time.
Wait for what? Huh? Suhasini? Sir.
Yes, Vishal. What's the matter?
Sir, tomorrow the inquiry procedure, I request you to please stop that.
Why?
Because the ones whom we've arrested, they are not related to the attack.
But how can you say that without any inspection?
Sir, whether you believe me or not, I spoke to Suhasini.
Suhasini?
Yes, sir. Suhasini Rastogi, my fiancé.
Inspector Vishal, are you out of your mind?
Yes, sir. I know very well what I'm telling you, sir. I went to the place where her last rites were performed. And that is where she told me this.
Stop it, Vishal. Stop this nonsense. See, your fiancé Suhasini died in that bomb blast, I understand. It has affected you a lot, but I did not expect that this attack can affect you to such an extent that you will do injustice towards your duty. I never expected this out of you, Vishal.
Sir, please believe me. Whatever I'm telling you, that's the truth. It's my request. Please stop the inquiry procedure. Otherwise, this press and media will get a chance to make fun of our department.
Vishal, you take a 1 month leave and go out for some time. I will give this case to Inspector Kulkarni for handling.
What are you saying, sir? You can't do this to me.
Vishal, it's my order. And now you will not handle this case. Inquiry commission will happen tomorrow.
But sir, you...
You may leave.
Right, sir.
Thank you.
What am I supposed to do, Suhasini? I'm unable to think. I met you today. But nobody believes me. Even Ranjit sir doesn't believe me. Suhasini, I can see you, I can talk to you. Is it just an illusion? You tell me, Suhasini. I really don't think that you're an illusion.
I'm illusion for others. But for you, I'm a reality, Vishal. From now, whatever you will say, every word of yours will be believed. I have an important information for you. It's really serious. Just listen carefully. Today at 12 o'clock, the local train, which will start from Church Gate to Andheri, in that bogie number 4 at Matunga station, the same criminal, he's going for another bomb blast attack.
What?
Yes. That bomb will be inside in a bag. You need to rush. We don't have time. Reach Matunga station. You need to leave.
The local from Churchgate to Andheri will be arriving on platform number 1. The train arriving at platform number 2 is 10 minutes late.
Move! Please move aside.
Side.
Clear this compartment. Just leave.
Let's go.
Run, there is a bomb in the bag. Leave from here. Leave.
Chalo.
Move. Move. Everyone move.
Vishal?
Sir.
Vishal, you saved the lives of many people and also averted a big mishap.
It is my duty, sir.
But you shouldn't have jeopardized your life in this way. If the bomb would have blasted in your hands then, you should have informed the bomb disposal squad.
I didn't have that much time, sir. I reached the compartment and told the people to leave from there. But there were people in other compartments as well. And to save their lives, I had no other choice left. That's the reason I just ran with the bag and threw it in the opposite direction.
But I'm still unable to understand this thing. How did you come to know about the occurrence of this mishap?
Sir, you think this is some kind of illusion? It might be. But I got to know the...
That means tomorrow, the inquiry procedure will have to be stopped.
Hello?
We have been informed right now that a Mumbai's Matunga station, a bomb blast has occurred. But a police officer's vigilance has saved many people's lives. And there has been no casualties.
Huh?
Mr. Vishal, there is a question. How did you get to know that there is a bomb in the train?
I'm sorry. But right now I can't tell you anything about it. Inquiry is under process. It's a legal proceeding. It might take some time.
Were you not afraid when you ran with the bag?
No, I just wanted to save these innocent people. It means everything to me. From then, I don't get affected by anything. Nothing can stop me from doing my duty. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah!
The size of the bag is actually not that big, guys. And there is a belt here. And in the center there are two belts. There are side two pockets on both the sides.
Sir, the bag with the side pockets.
And a bit, No. Do it again.
The side pocket, the belt, I think...
The size of the bag is a little medium size and the pockets should be here on both the sides. And there is a flap on the opposite side and zip.
Have a look.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Kulkarni?
Yes, sir.
See this. This is the sketch of that bag, which was used for the bomb blast.
Yeah.
Just go to the market and check who makes these kind of bags. And also find out who uses these bags more often.
Yes, sir.
Suhasini?
Yes, Vishal.
Suhasini, this bag is...
Yes, Vishal. It's like the same bag that attacker uses.
Yes, Suhasini. This is the same bag that I have thrown out of the compartment. I tried a lot, but that attacker... We're still unable to find him. When I reached that compartment, I deliberately warned the people about it. But there was no such face on whom I could suspect. Although, in this bomb blast, there is no major damage. But even after all of this, the attacker is still free. We haven't been able to identify him. But, Suhasini, if you have seen him, then tell me something about him. Tell me, Suhasini.
When I was alive, I did not see him. When in the compartment, I was keeping my shopping bag. Then I noticed a hand that kept that bomb bag in it. I could not see his face. But while leaving, I saw his legs. Now I know him. But for you, now his identity is only his bag.
Okay, Suhasini. Now me and my whole department will surely find that attacker who has this kind of bag.
Yes. That's the only way. You also try. I will also try. But one thing is sure. I won't leave him.
Suhas. I know that we've stopped this attack, but we still don't have any clue which can help us identify the terrorist. And Inspector Vishal here.
You are getting famous day by day for your heroics, Inspector Vishal. TV channels. Press conference. Media has made you a hero of your department, yeah?
Thank you. May I know who am I speaking to?
Officer! I am the one who is behind this dreadful attack which you have stopped. You think that you are really brave enough to stop me? You think you are smart enough because you could save the lives of these people, yeah? But listen, whatever you wanted to do, you did it. But it's my turn now, so I will do my bit, but I promise. This time I won't fail. I won't fail, Inspector. Inspector Vishal! Challenging you to stop this massacre from destroying the city. Stop if you can. If I am not wrong, you are very proud of your uniform, right? I think it's the greed of the medal that made you chase me.
Listen.
You just listen to me. Not j- just one station. There will be blast at many, many stations now. Not just thousands, but people will die in lakhs.
Lakhs of them.
Now you tell me, how will you and your department save these people? And how many people you save, Inspector? You will get tired, right?
You... Hello? 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 Damn it.
Sir, call came from this number.
This number. Come on, follow me. Follow. Go check inside.
Yes, sir.
Fast. Oh, God.
Sir, there is no one in this house.
Oh, no. I think he has left on his mission. Kulkarni.
Yes,
just
sir.
Do one thing. Declare red alert on every railway station immediately and go and personally check about it.
Okay,
come on,
sir.
Move. Suhasini. Yes. Suhasini, where are you? Where are you, Suhasini? I need your help right now. See, today, the life of these innocent people is at stake. Suhasini, I'm here to meet you. I need you right now, Suhasini. Suhasini, please come here. Please come, Suhasini. Suhasini! Where are you, Suhasini? Please come here, Suhasini. Suhasini, please come here.
Check it properly. Here, give it to me. Show it to me. You may leave. Can go. Check everyone.
Please pay attention. The local train from Churchgate to Andheri will be arriving at platform number 1.
Okay. Check this back properly. You may leave. Give me the bag.
Kindly pay attention. Smoking inside the train is prohibited.
Please note, smoking is not allowed inside a train.
Thank you. Are you?
I will surely tell you everything. On 6th March evening, railway station, same compartment, there was a bomb blast attack. Many people died in it. Out of that, I am one of them. My name, Suhasini Rastogi.
What?
Yes. At the same evening, it was my engagement. After the shopping, I was returning home. But that bomb blast took my life.
No, no.
The place you are standing, have a look. My dead body was burnt there. I was the only child of my parents. They wanted me to have a good life. Even I wanted to live. I have spent my 21 years in studies. And in educating myself, just to have a better lifestyle. But you had shattered all my dreams. My dream of a happy life. What wrong did I do? What made you do this? Why did you do this to me? Answer me.
Yes, I have. I have taken revenge. My house was burned. My parents. My siblings were burnt alive. I even went to the police station to report about it. But But instead of listening to my story, they forcefully locked me up in jail. I ran out of the jail somehow. And then I made a decision that I will take revenge. I will definitely take revenge. I will destroy everything.
But whatever happened to you, I was not part of that. I did not burn your house. The ones who died in bomb blast or got injured, they were not responsible for the death of your family members. Then why did you took revenge on us? If someone had exploited you, did injustice to you, and even police did not help you out, then you could have gone to press. Media was there to help you. Many social organizations were there. Human Rights Commission was there. People who believe in justice were there. And above all, there is a law and order. If someone was exploited, but just to take revenge, to target innocent people, to target because of their hatred, then the whole society, entire city, and our nation will start killing each other in the name of revenge. The ones who have killed your family, don't think that they will not suffer. Today or tomorrow, law and order will definitely punish them for their sins. And they will not be spared. But what you did, taking law in your hands, and who gave you this right to spread this terror?
You're absolutely right. I couldn't see anything beyond hatred and revenge. I had lost all my senses in anger. I didn't even realize that people who died in the blast, they were innocent people just like my family. Very much innocent. They had nothing to do with my loss. I am a culprit. I have committed a very big sin. I don't deserve to be alive. Punish me. Punish me as much as you want to. I will accept the punishment. I will accept it.
Whoever you are, whatever is your name, whatever is your religion, I have got you here to kill you by burning you alive. Just like the way you kill others. But now I will not do this. Because if I will do this, then what will be the difference between you and me? Go. I have forgiven you from my side. I don't know what police will have to do with you. But before I leave, I want to tell you something. Fire can only give rise to fire. Hatred and revenge can only lead to war, rights, and differences among people. Hatred and anger leads to bloodshed. It ruins families. It can never fulfill anyone's revenge, but can only lead to destruction. But that punishment affects years of lives. Go. I have forgiven you.
Suhasini, that?
Yes, Vishal. He came here. And he even got punished for his sins. This punishment, not given by law, but by God. From the bomb, which he used to kill innocent people, today the same bomb took his life. I had forgiven him anyways.
Suhasini, I have a huge regret that he's not just ruined his life. But along with his life, he has ruined my life as well, along with his own. You were my future, Suhasini. I have lost you forever, Suhasini.
No, Vishal. Life is a journey. In this, people meet us. People leaves us also. But the journey still continues. Just before I leave, I have one message. That life is not a name of hatred. It's the name of love.
Suhas.